Hi everybody and welcome back to Relax My Dog. And now today's video is really exciting and kind of important if you are allergic to dogs. Now with sort of dog allergies at an all-time high at the moment, it means that a lot of people are wanting to find a particular dog breed that is hypoallergenic. And we're actually going to split this video into two different categories. Today we're going to be talking about big dog breeds, and then next week we're also going to be talking about smaller dog breeds as well. So it depends what sort of dog breed you prefer, whether you prefer a bigger dog like Milo or a smaller dog. So before we do get started, definitely do go down below to the comments and let me know any bigger dog breeds that you know that are hypoallergenic. I would absolutely love to hear your guys' thoughts, but we are going to be talking about five different dog breeds within this video. So let's just get started. Now the first dog breed I have actually never really heard of, and that is the Portuguese water dog. Now the Portuguese water dog is known to be loyal and energetic. Their coat sheds a very little amount, but they do require regular grooming, so it might be quite a costly dog to have. But if you are looking for a hypoallergenic dog, I think most of them do need proper grooming quite often to make sure they're not molting and their hair is fresh. Now these dogs are actually quite a rare breed. I mean, I never heard of them, so maybe you guys haven't either. But a fun fact about this dog is that President Obama actually bought one of these dogs for his daughters, which I think is pretty cool. Now the second hypoallergenic dog breed is one that is sort of split up into three categories, but today we're going to be talking about a poodle, but just a standard poodle, as I do know they have a toy one and they also have miniatures, but we're just going to be talking about a standard poodle today. Obviously, as most of you guys do know, a poodle is one of the most popular dog breeds in the world. Another fact about a poodle is that they hardly ever shed their fur, so they are also perfect if you are hypoallergenic because you won't find their fur all over the place or in the air or anything like that. Then our third dog breed is a labradoodle, and obviously a labradoodle is a crossbreed dog combined with a Labrador and also a poodle as well. Now well-bred labradoodles are naturally friendly and an active dog, and they also make great family pets. However, it is important to note that a Labrador does actually molt quite a bit, but a poodle obviously doesn't. So if you combine them together, there are going to be different variations of if they do molt, but it's definitely something that if you get from a well-bred owner, they will be able to tell you if they are hypoallergenic, because obviously if their parents are, they will be as well. It is also important to note that try and get a labradoodle whose parents are a labradoodle and a labradoodle, or rather than a Labrador and a poodle. It's important to get one that is already crossbreed from the generation before, because then they are more likely to be more hypoallergenic. Our fourth dog breed is an Afghan hound. Now the Afghan hound is a hound that is distinguished by its thick, fine, silky coat and its tail with a ring curl at the end. It's actually difficult to believe, if you do see a picture of these dogs, that they are hypoallergenic. I mean, it's difficult to say that a dog is hypoallergenic because not all dogs can be 100% hypoallergenic, so it's difficult to sort of say that. But whenever you look at this dog, it is hard to believe that they do not shred fur, because there is so much fur on them. But it is true, they are a hypoallergenic dogs, and they are a lot better for someone that has a dog allergy. And then our very last dog breed is an Irish Water Spaniel. Now an Irish Water Spaniel actually looks very similar to a poodle, because they do have extremely curly hair. However, it is believed that these sort of dogs do require brushing every few weeks and trimming every 2 months to neaten and shape the coat, and to also make sure that they don't molt or don't shred as much. It's also recommended that regular grooming of a dog can actually improve if you do have allergies as well, so another important thing to note. But that is it for this week's video. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Don't forget to comment down below, and also don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Also don't forget to enter our gorgeous little t-shirt giveaway. They just look like this. All you need to do to win your very own t-shirt is pop over to Instagram, post a picture of your dog and tag us at @thatsmydog, and then you've entered. It really is that simple. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and me and Miley here. We'll see you all next week for next week's video. Bye.